warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Saya, Sumaya binti Muhammad Rehan, akan menjadi pengacara anda untuk dokumentari kami. Tajuk tugasan kami ialah Sumbangan Tamadun Islam Terhadap Barat. Saksikan untuk mengetahui dengan lebih lanjut.
Seperti yang kita tahu, tamadun Islam telah melahirkan ribuan ulama' dan ilmuwan dalam pelbagai bidang, sama ada dalam bidang teologi, fiqah, bahasa, falsafah, sains dan teknologi. Semasa tamadun Islam pada abad pertengahan, iaitu sehingga abad ke-14 Masihi, berada di dalam kegemilangannya, Barat masih lagi dalam zaman kegelapannya. Barat ketika itu masih memusuhi sains dan melihat sains sesuatu yang bertentangan dengan agama Kristian. Bahkan, pengembang ilmu sains dan falsafah telah dituduh kafir dan dihukum bunuh, dibakar atau dipenjarakan. Semasa Barat berada dalam zaman kemundurannya, ketika itu beberapa orang sarjananya mula beralih ke timur mempelajari ilmu falsafah, sains dan teknologi dari ulama-ulama Islam sama ada di Baghdad, Sicily, Andalusia dan di kota-kota Islam. Mari kita menonton klip ringkas tentang tokoh-tokoh Islam yang terkemuka ini. Saksikan.
Welcome to the Dark Ages, or as it should be known, the Golden Ages.
Who are you?
I am Al-Jazari, engineer and ingenious inventor.
I thought you said this was the Dark Ages. It doesn't look very dark.
That's because it's all a matter of perspective, my soon-to-be illuminated friend. Of course, there are parts of the world that weren't dark at all, but in a civilization that stretched from Spain to China, the golden rays of discovery and invention shone over everything.
What civilization?
The Muslim civilization, my young friend. Through scholars and scientists of various faiths, some of the most important discoveries known to man were made at this time. Discoveries that drew on knowledge of the ancients, but have more connections with your modern world than you could possibly ever imagine.
Like what?
Well, all sorts of things.
I've got to get a picture of this.
I knew it was a good idea.
Who are you?
Allow me to introduce Ibn al-Haytham, a great scientist whose ideas led to the invention of the camera.
You invented the camera?
I laid the foundations for modern cameras by explaining how our eyes work. I found a way of projecting an image onto another surface through a small hole in a dark room, later called camera obscura.
Think of all the things that evolved from this discovery. Cameras, cinema, all share the same principle.
Cool.
Look out below!
Who's that?
That's my good friend, Abbas ibn Farnas, who gazed up to the heavens passionate in his belief that man could fly.
Whoa.
Indeed, he dared to dream about flying 1,000 years before the Wright brothers. You know, you all take your jet-setting holidays for granted, so it only seems fair to remember Abbas ibn Farnas.
Stand by! I'm ready for takeoff!
You did forget one thing, though. A tail, useful for landing.
Ah! My back! Is there a doctor in the house?
Did someone call?
Ah, my old friend, why don't you introduce yourself to my young guests?
I am Abul Qasim al-Zahrawi. Many call me the father of surgery.
Did you actually do surgery back then?
Of course we did. In fact, many of the surgical tools that I invented are still used in your modern hospitals. Excuse me, a patient needs my attention. Scalpel?
I think I may need some stitches.
In that case, I'll use catgut.
Catgut?
From the gut of animals. Perfect for stitching up internal wounds. Your surgeons are still using it today. Sorry, mustache.
Who's she?
That's Mariam al-Astrolabi, one of the many brilliant women of her time. She made sophisticated astrolabes.
Astro what?
Astrolabes. They show the sky and the stars on a small flat plate you can hold in your hand. Think of them as ancient calculating or timekeeping devices. Today you have your watch, your compass, satellite navigation, helping people and explorers travel the world. Science at its brilliant best.
And all these things were developed during the Golden Ages.
And that's just the tip of the iceberg. There were thousands of other inventions. all areas of life, and in the years that followed, their influence spread across the whole of medieval Europe. So you see, it wasn't so dark after all.
What about you?
Me?
What did you invent?
Well, I don't want to be big-headed, but I made some groundbreaking advances in engineering. I suppose my most significant discovery converted rotary motion into linear motion using a crank and connecting rod. It's essential in pumps and engines. In fact, I've no idea how the Industrial Revolution could have happened hundreds of years later without such a device. Not that I ever get the credit I deserve. But my crowning glory was my amazing time-telling machine, my legendary elephant clock.
It's a clock.
Yes. Dozens of components collected from different cultures around the world. Indian, Greek, Arabian, Egyptian, Chinese.
Wow. A United Nations clock. That is pretty cool. Does it actually tell the time?
Wow. Yes, of course. If it wasn't for me, thousands of people would be late for everything. Speaking of time, we better get you back. And remember, spread the word. This was a golden age. And I've only shown you a tiny part of this wondrous time. There are countless other scientists and inventions directly connected to your modern world. You're just going to have to find out for yourselves.
The light.
Sekarang, mari kita mendengar pula suatu pendapat tentang sumbangan tamadun Islam terhadap Barat dari segi perspektif yang berbeza.
Jadi kalau kita lihat dalam Islam tu, bila kita sebut nama Islam, kita tidak hanya tengok kepada aspek yang material sahaja, kan? Kita tengok keseluruhan. Jadi bagaimana akhlak seseorang Muslim, itulah dia hasil daripada Islam dan itulah dia tamadun yang nak dibina. Tamadun yang berasaskan kepada akhlak. Kalau dari segi aspek inilah kan, aspek hubungan antara manusia dengan manusia, individu dengan individu. Jadi kalau pada pandangan saya lah, kalau nak cerita pasal tamadun Islam ni, kita lihat itu adalah tamadun yang bersumberkan pada Islam. Kalau adanya macam contohnya architecture, wah cantik bangunan, masjid dan sebagainya, alright, fantastic. Tapi asasnya kepada Islam tu. That means there is a connection between what is the physical, apa je ilmu, apa saja kehebatan ni semua ni. Semuanya kalau dia tu tadi bersumberkan dari Islam, dia akan mencirikan satu ciri yang terpenting sekali, iaitu mengajak manusia dan alam makhluk ni semua lah untuk submit to Allah SWT.
Oleh itu, kita sebagai umat Islam perlu bukan sahaja menguasai bidang-bidang ilmu di dunia ini, tetapi perlu mengkaitkan setiap satunya dengan kekuasaan Allah supaya hati kita lebih dekat dan kita akan lebih mencintainya. Selain itu, dalam masyarakat Muslim dan non-Muslim pula, setiap dari mereka perlu menerapkan nilai-nilai yang murni supaya hidup bersama akan lebih aman dan harmoni. Sekian sahaja daripada kumpulan kami. Yang baik itu daripada Allah dan yang buruk itu daripada kelemahan saya sendiri. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.